Hi students, I hope you all studied the previous portion. What we learned in the previous class? We learned the seven characteristics of living beings. We also looked into the first feature, feeding, in detail. What are the seven characteristics of all living beings? Feeding, breathing, throwing out waste, growing, moving, responding, and reproducing. Studied the first feature, feeding, in detail. Now let's look into the second feature, breathing. Breathe. Can we live without breathing? How long can we hold our breath? Only a few seconds. So, we know that we can't live without breathing. So does other living beings. We take in air. The air contains oxygen. We use that oxygen present in the air to produce energy. You might have experienced difficulty in breathing in rooms without proper ventilation. This is because we need air to breathe. You have already learned that the food gives us energy. The energy to walk, jump, play, all this comes from the food we eat. Do you know how the food we eat gets converted to energy? I will explain how. Inside the body of a living being, the oxygen combines with the food to produce energy. Carbon dioxide and water vapor are also produced. We breathe out these carbon dioxide and water vapor. Okay. What all happens in the process of breathing? First, we take in air containing oxygen. This oxygen combines with food to produce energy. Carbon dioxide and water vapor are also produced, thrown out by the living beings together with the unused part of air. All living beings breathe. Different animals use different parts of their body to breathe. How we breathe? Let's take a short breath. Which part we use to breathe? We used our nose. So, all human beings take in and throw out air through their nose. Other animals like cats, cow, tigers and lions breathe through their nose. Birds breathe through nostrils on or above their beak. How do birds breathe? In birds, nostrils are present on or above their beak. Breathe. In birds, nostrils are present on or above their beak. And birds breathe through these nostrils. Frogs and earthworms breathe through their skin. In insects, there are holes on their sides. They breathe through these holes. Let's take the case of a fish. From where do we get oxygen? From where? We get it from the air. But fishes live in water. How will they get oxygen? Water contains oxygen. Fish take in oxygen from the water. We can't do this. If we jump into the water, what will happen? We will be drowned if you don't know swimming. Why can't we take in oxygen from water? Fishes have a special organ called gills. Gills help them to take in oxygen from the water. Okay, now we have learned the different breathing organs of different animals. Human beings and other animals like cats, dogs, cows, tigers, and lions breathe through their nose. Birds breathe through nostrils on or above their beak. Insects breathe through holes on their sides. Frogs and earthworm breathe through their skin. Fish take in oxygen from the water with the help of gills. I hope all of you understood the topic. Have a nice day. Thank you.